Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to a new video, and it's me, V9 in Scratch. So recently I haven't been uploading anything in Scratch except this one. If you guys don't know, I basically ordered a set of Rubik's Cubes, and yep, only 1% of the viewers who's watching my videos have currently subscribed. So if you may not prove that wrong, just press the subscribe button. Sometimes YouTube glitches, making you unsubscribe. So my last one, which I made, was like on March 5th, 2022. And today is March 13th, and it's not completely done. It's a modified version of the original one. So please check out my original channel. My main IRL channel. I got many videos there, and I'll be uploading soon, I promise. And I'm just gonna begin this video. So I worked on this button detector over here. Just press add to studio. I flag the stop button and the cancel button, the pause button. It just finds everything, even including the C data button. It uses a cloud variable, writes down set of codes and works. So today we're gonna be making something new. By that I mean we made platformer assault and basic platformer, basically both of them are the same stuff. But today I'm gonna be updating this game. You can clearly see it works like a platformer but has nothing to do, no commands, but it's out of the studio. Okay, it's a cool video game, I agree on that. So today we're gonna be upgrading this simple game over here, and we're gonna be trying to bring this to the next level, and it's quite easy. So okay, so let's just look inside of the project. We just made, I think. Okay, so its costume is the same. You can run it from 1 to 5 if it just has one. So now we are the maximum minimize size. Now okay with this, so I'm just gonna press the group button. Now we can ungroup this. So let's just ungroup that over here. I'm gonna press this, duplicate it, and then this is gonna be the original one. Remember that. Group this. So on this side, the other side, over here, let's just take some land. I'm just borrowing land. Don't worry. I'm just borrowing land. Press copy, get out of here, and paste it. Okay, our game's about to be done. Just kidding. So anything which goes over the side immediately get destroyed in this point of view. So yeah, you cannot really move it out of here. The only method is to group them all and move them. So that's what I'm currently working on. And yeah, I'm working on this game. I didn't even have a name for it. So if you got a name, leave it down below. So I don't know where this goes. I'm just gonna add a small area so the players don't get in here. No, wait, that's too boring. So I'm gonna make something like this about. Please don't ask me what that is. I don't know what it is. Okay, so I'm just gonna move it a bit up about. No, that's quite boring. So perfect, we get that going, and let's just make the short, make it like a stage block. I don't know, I'll just press the back button once. Nope, let it be in the front view. Now that looks perfect. So let's just run the game, and yeah, that looks pretty bad actually. Just put that back one Leo, put this back one Leo, put this back front, and this is also gonna be moved to the front layer. So guys, you don't have to. So yeah, it's really gang. So now I'm also gonna work on the other thing. So, I'm going to fill with these pencils. Let's just give it a run right now. Okay, that's what I want. That's perfect. Okay, yeah. Now, we here on this side, would we just work like a gate? I don't know, that's not gonna happen. I'm sorry. Your ideas are frictional. Just bring this front. And now, our game is done. Okay, not that one. This one. So, yeah, guys, it's working pretty well. And I'll just meet you guys after the show. So, guys, I'm just gonna update that things. Very, very sorry for the voice disturbances. It was not me. Clearly not me. Yeah, so let's just go on working on our stuff. So I'm just gonna go on mute and then start working on this. So guys, it basically seems so the problem is, what do I do? I basically tried to make this like a jumbo's blow, but it didn't work out, so I gotta code other things. And basically, if I just go here, and I'm just gonna go mute. Perfect. We are done. So I'm gonna work on other details in the game, and I'm gonna try to add new things later on. First, I'm gonna add a small storyline system. So let's just do it, and I'm gonna pass the so guys, it basically seems so I am just doing it properly. But the fact is, I wasn't able to do it right and I just deleted it. So, yeah, guys, I'm just gonna work on that once again or redo it. So, the story is gonna go something weird, I guess. As every game has a storyline, even including Super Mario Bros. For some reason. Yeah, each and every single castle you go, they just tell you to go to another castle. Like, it's kind of like a storyline. So, now. Here's how I'm gonna do it. I'm not gonna choose a sprite, except I'm gonna make one by pressing this button. Now it's gonna be gray, blackish in color, I guess. This one's perfect. Yeah, I'll just go with this. No, it's not good, but that's okay. I'm just gonna set this to 0. It looks perfect. Now the next thing which I have to do is I shall make it transparent, which I'm gonna do over here, and it requires a little work. So I just make this small enough, move it, fit it in screen. No wait, I can even make it design like when it pops out like this, and it tells you a story. So okay, I don't know, I'm not gonna work on that currently, but this seems to be perfect. So if I get into the code, it just has the ability to fade in. If I go to my looks, come down, now here, change. Okay, I'll just grab the set too. So if I press this, and if I select ghost, you could see it's transformed. So I'll just set this to ghost effect to 0. So over here, you can clearly see how well it has been doing. So I just press this 2 times, so that means we're gonna do 25 plus 25, so it's 50. Yeah, I can just do the calculation by myself. So set ghost effect to 50 and start it. Now it doesn't seem to work as we didn't add the press green flag. Now I'm just gonna go over here. I know it's black in color, but let's just add a still line. Oh, here, yeah, that's pretty weird from what we usually see from that. So I'm gonna set the handwriting to this weird Chinese text, I guess. Hello. Okay. H-E-L-L-O. So I don't know what still line to add, but you guys could help me out on season 2. Hello. It's been a long time. Okay, I'll just put on our empire has been. Okay, I'll just press another enter. Nope, that's perfect. Been in control of, I don't know what name. So control of the note named as, oh, I got a perfect name. Me. Okay, that's not the name. So it has been control of the red bed. I don't know, that looks pretty weird. No, it's pretty weird. Just me that's only about that. I just pressed this wrong key. I don't know why. Okay, so it has been control of the red bed team. I don't know, I just remember what bed was, and you know the time when red team is always in front of you. Yeah, so let's just start working on this. You are the last survivor. The spelling right? Okay, I don't know. Sorry if it's wrong. You are the last survivor. Whoa. So good. And now, that's quite easy. And we're done. So over here we are going to our first 2 lines of code done. So I'm gonna add a small repeat loop plus the wait one second and change ghost effect minus Now I'm gonna find 25 divided by 2, which I don't know what it is, so let's just divide 25 by 2. So guys, it has been a while and I'm currently working on it once again. So it doesn't fade in as much smooth as I thought it did. So I don't know what to do now. But we still got it working now. It's time to work on the level. So the game seems to be working well, and it's time to work on updating the platform. So I'm gonna be doing this until the time is 5:30. Of course, yeah, it's like 1 minute, but I'm pretty sure we could get some kind of progress going into that. So let's just get started. And I'm gonna be passing the video off cam. I promise I'm not doing something else. It's old idea of me, so let's just go on. So guys, it has been a while and I have did a lot of progress. It has been 5:26 and we started over very before. It has been more than 15 minutes. So the game has a better text system and the first level is kind of hard. I don't know if I'd be able to make it for the video completely showcase you guys. Oh yeah, I did it. But it seems so we just encounter a problem. Hey, that's above expand. Now basically right. So the random spawn system has been completely offed. So over here, as you guys can clearly see, it works good. Just gonna go on mute and show you guys a full screen gameplay. So it seems the game is impossible, so I'm just gonna give a small update and end this video over there. So let's just start working on that. So now the video is gonna end over here, but nothing else than an amazing gameplay. So let's just begin the amazing gameplay. So we start down. Hello, it has been a long time since our empire has been controlled by the Red Bear team. You are the last survivor. Go down now. So I got perfect time to read that, and now you're just gonna hop on to this world when you start. Of course, yeah, this game is available on Scratch. Make sure to follow me and. It's basically possible, believe me or not, it's possible, but the first level is hard enough. So it goes on something like this over here. You're gonna jump from here. Okay, yeah, that's perfect. I told you it was possible. From here to here, and then from here you're gonna do the mega jump. Okay, that clearly wasn't a mega jump, so I guess it has not a problem with the platformer game. So let's just go over here, copy this, and then I'm gonna move this land over here, then let's just paste it. Now no more box in the game, the game's just gonna work perfectly fine. Let's just put this and move it so that we spawn over here. So you just gotta fall from this crosshair over there. So everything's going perfect. So let's just end this with a normal gameplay, and I'm gonna be publishing this video on 1750 if you're ever wondering. I don't know. Okay, so yeah, this is basically the past. You're watching this from the future, and I know that clearly. You would be at least 33 seconds or that. So, okay, I was a fool. So, okay. I don't know why I made this game this hard. So, if the players escape the first level, they get to go to the second level, where there are these high rogues. Okay, I just fell into the void or the pit. So, it's near impossible to get out of here. That is why this game is this hard. I nearly called this the world's most hardest game of my own version. So, I guess the game's working fine, but the only downside is I'm not able to get out there, so how am I supposed to do that? That's my only doubt. Okay, so I just did it. Oh, yeah, that's working, that's perfect. And then you'd be let down to the world. So, I'm gonna be updating later on, and every time you end it, this also shows up. So, bye guys, make you another video. And make sure to check out and subscribe to my channel. And bye guys, see you in another video.